Miss Debbie Patton of Odessa, Texas, Miss Teenage of 1970 of America. This is the final preparation for Miss Teenage America pageant to be televised nationwide this evening. It's full dress rehearsal time in the Tarrant County Convention Center with dozens of beautiful teenage girls, dancers, Master of Ceremonies Dick Clark, singer Sergio Franchi, and the Hobo Band. One of the eight finalists will be crowned the new Miss Teenage America 1971 tonight. The finalists include Lou Jean Fison of Richmond, Virginia, Stephanie Cutler of Omaha, Nebraska, Michelle McCabe, Minneapolis, St. Paul, Patrice King, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, Marion Guilford of Jacksonville, Florida, Terry Yavitz of St. Louis, Missouri, Joy Cancels, Charleston, West Virginia, and Rewa Walsh of Los Angeles, California. Giving up her crown will be the current Miss Teenage America, Debbie Patton of Odessa. Tonight's pageant will mark the 10th anniversary of this occasion, and it's expected to be the most successful. Jim Green, Channel 8 News on the Move, Fort Worth.
How is this trip financed?
This trip is being financed by contributions from individuals and by contribution from the DCA.
And what is the purpose now of their going to Washington?
This is a group of clients, board members of legal services, clients of legal services, and community organizers working with clients of legal services who are going to Washington to make known their concern about the threats to the existence of legal services to the Congress of the United States.
The action that has been taken in Washington that these people are going to demonstrate against, and the recent activities here locally, and the resignation of Bennett Miller, do you think that all of these things indicate perhaps an ever-increasing danger to the loss of OEO programs?
I absolutely do. Yes.
This Cook's Discount Department Store and all others like it have been enjoined by the court. Judge D. Brown Walker made the decision after 2 days of testimony and pleadings before his court by Sundico and Cook's Discount Department Store lawyers. Miss Mary Stewart brought the case before the court because she says that she couldn't understand why the store could operate on consecutive Saturdays and Sundays, and other stores couldn't. She believed that it was against the law. Various evidence of non-essential items were presented to the court that were bought on consecutive Saturdays and Sundays. Judge Walker granted the temporary injunction against the stores and ordered them not to be open tomorrow. The previous procedure was to sell all holdings of Cook Discount Department Store to Sundico on Saturday night and to buy it back again on Monday morning. The management here at this store says that they'll probably be open tomorrow because they won't have any contact with their top management until Monday morning. Judge Walker went on to say that if Cook Discount Department Stores continue to operate in this fashion, then maybe the Attorney General of Texas should look into their charter and just put them out of business completely. For Channel 8 News on the Move, this is Jess Brown.
like for you to meet a friend of mine. This is John Doe Dog. Come here, John. John is one of 65 dogs and 50 cats currently being sheltered at the Tarrant County Humane Society in Fort Worth. He was abandoned 3 days ago with his brother in a garbage can somewhere in Fort Worth. At the present time, facilities at the Tarrant County Humane Society are woefully inadequate to care for guys like John Doe Dog. So today they're having a rummage sale to see what they can do about it to raise a little bit of money. Now with this, they're going to buy some new surgical instruments for their operating room, various and sundry other equipment that they need here awfully bad. If you'd like to have a dog or a cat, it's like John Doe Dog here, just come on by anytime. They've got plenty of them for you, big dogs, little dogs, fat dogs, and skinny dogs. All you add is love. This is Jerry Park, Channel 8 News on the Move, Fort Worth.